engage. So when we had our meeting, or the week that we started in September, the burden for Scott County was 4.0, with 10 being the threshold of high. As far as the 21st, we are at 43.1, so we are 4 times the high threshold. And what that burden represents is not positives, but potential positives. And since we are bordered with Kentucky and some counties are close, in Tennessee, then we do not always get real-time information about positives. Taking pets and creeps, we're very fortunate that one of our local providers is often rapid tests. What we're seeing right now is a trend in specific schools. I'm sure that Mr. Smith shared the data with you about how many students are in quarantine, how many staff members are in quarantine, how many are positive. And that is probably not accurate because it is increasing at a rapid rate. Picking up several this afternoon. I think that when we were closed by the governor in March, I think we had a lot of changes in behaviors that maybe we weren't locally at that point that they were justifying, for lack of a better word. I just feel like right now we are at a cusp of running the risk of running out of staff members or responsible adults to supervise our children as far as subs. That's just based on the trends that I've experienced. That's not my opinion. Other than I'm seeing, I'm down 2 nurses. I have no sub nurses that have come in, except for possibly one, unless she's trained. We have 3 bus routes that are involved right now with possible quarantines. And we're awaiting results on several children. So I just wanted to share that with you. That's just factual data that I'm right now, where we are today. Do I have any questions?
I do. Excuse me.
This is a board.
Yeah, we can't come to a question and answer.
Do we get a chance to ask questions later?
No. We let them in there. So she's asking us if we have any questions.
Oh, apologize. Can we have a session later? Can I request that, please?
No, we go by this agenda.
For our elected officials, can we please have a question and answer session?
You had a public comment. You had your time to talk. Now we're listening to her, making a decision. So it's our time. She's asking us as a board as a whole, if we have any questions. Not to audience. Any of the board members got questions or anything for her? If not, thank you, Ms. Howard.
Thank you.
All right, Mr. Smith.
Mr. Chairman, board, first of all, I want to send regards from Mr. Ferguson, our superintendent. He absolutely wanted to be here this afternoon. He's had a family emergency that he has to attend to, so please keep his family in mind as we go forward. But we've had some discussion, and the first thing from the discussion that we've had from parents, I'd like to have a little bit of factual discussion of what we have, and I guess some reassurance of concerns that I was hearing from parents here. We really do appreciate any input that we have from our parents. My number one goal, my number one training that I have is to educate kids. There's nothing that I've had in 23 years, nor a bachelor's degree or a master's degree, that teaches me how to manage a pandemic. That is not, it's not my training or my forte to do. But we do a lot rely on our Virginia Department of Health, and I will say that they've done a fantastic job of helping us. When students are put into quarantine or they test positive, all that is consulted and worked through with the Virginia Department of Health, and our epidemiologist that makes those decisions for us. As far as my knowledge of what's best medically, that's not my forte to do that, even though over the time, unfortunately, I have gathered some knowledge that I wish I didn't have to gather for this. So when I'm talking about knowledge that we're looking at and the situation really the state of where Scott County is if we look at COVID within our county. When we met on August 4th as a board, initially we were going to open, the board voted to open us under the current plan of what we are under. Barometric changed at that time in August. At that time, our metric was 13.9 per 100,000. It was decided at that time that we would move to pre-K through 3, special ed and English language learners would be on site, 4 through 12 would be remote. And we were that way until our September 8th meeting. We met at our September 8th meeting and we looked at our overall metric. It was 8.6 per 100,000 is what we looked at there. Our board decided at that point in time to return kids back onto site under our current learning plan that we have, 4 days a week, Wednesday being remote learning, and our day ending at 2 o'clock. When we met in October, just a few short weeks ago, on October 6th, our metric per 100,000 was 9.3 incidents per 100,000. Board took no action at that time to change our learning module. It was below that 10 threshold, and we were in good shape. Today, as we meet, as of October 23rd, our metric is 43.1 per 100,000, which is, as Howard said, is 4 times the acceptable amount, or it's a high amount, is what they deem as high. Our previous high that we had in our metric was on August 13th, which was 29.9. And that was in that time that the board had voted to do partial in-person and remote learning. That's the information that is provided from us from the Virginia Department of Health. The other part that provided for you all to look at, and some reassurance to our folks, the other thing that I want to give you all some reassurance as an educator, and this is a personal part, I do not speak as every educator in Scott County in this, please know that. But I feel kids learn best with the teacher in the room. I feel that's how is the best learning module that we have. And I've worked with Mr. Ferguson for 10 years in this office, and I can easily speak for him and say that's his opinion also. So our goal is making recommendations and discussing with our board is keeping our kids in school. That's what we want to do. But we are also unfortunately tasked to look at the health of our students, the health of our staff, and the health of our people. And when we look at metrics within Scott County, and several of you all mentioned this, we are reasonable enough to look to see that not every school is feeling the impact of COVID right now. And for us as educators, it would probably not be wise of us to recommend something differently for something that's working right now. Our mitigation strategies are working in most, if not all, of our schools. When we are seeing some positive results of students, we're not seeing spread within the school. So that tells us that children possibly are contracting COVID outside of our school, but fortunately it's not seeing as great a spread within our school. With the exception of this week, we are starting to see an uptick in Gay City Middle School and Gay City High School. When I pulled information for our board to review our schools, at the time we had 4 positive cases that we were currently dealing with at Gay City Middle School, and we were dealing with 1 positive case in Gay City High School. Because of those positives, though, we have 37 students in quarantine at Gay City Middle School and 53 students in quarantine at Gay City High School. Since 2 o'clock, 1:30 when I pulled this data, we've had 4 additional positives at Gay City Middle School. We've had 1 additional positive at Gay City High School with another suspected positive awaiting results, which will begin tomorrow as additional contact tracing within those schools with the Virginia Department of Health to see what our next move should be. So working with Mr. Ferguson and talking to that, what he would like for you all to do as a board as we consider reopening is not looking at a unilateral decision for all schools based on a metric with the county, but to look at what we are seeing within our schools individually. I think for the most part, our educators want our kids in school and they want them with them. One of the reasons that I can say that is I look out here at individuals that have shown up to work since day one with our kids. I don't have teachers saying, I don't want to educate or work with our kids. We have people that have reworked everything that they have known in short amount of days and months for the best of our children. So if we can keep those kids with our children, I think that is best personally for our kids. But I believe right now at Gay City Middle School, Gay City High School, we need a short duration of remote learning for those kids so we can contact trace properly, we can clean sufficiently, and cause this not to cause more kids to be on quarantine. And I do mean short. I don't want to see, preferably, if you all are in agreement, months or even weeks upon weeks of this. I think if you all would be interested in that, maybe we could look at a 5-day remote learning from Gay City Middle School and High School. So that would start on Monday. And if we could return them back to school on Thursday after the Wednesday that is remote anyways, and Tuesday is our election day, I believe we'll have time for our kids that are already in quarantine to be able to return back to school and learning. And the duration should be short enough that it not cause greater issue than what we've already seen with kids not being with their teachers. Secondly, if you all are interested as a board in a request of Mr. Ferguson, is that we can look at these situations individually and look at where our schools are at and where that greatest need is, and let him consult with you and maybe do some short-term changes to the remote learning module so we can not affect a great number of kids if we do not have to do that. That would be our discussion within our office if you all would be interested in that. Some of the points that lead to that within this Gay City community, because of our uptick that we're seeing in Gay City Middle School and Gay City High School, Nurse Howard mentions where we have three buses now, but we are going to have to contact trace, which could mean a quarantine of those kids. We have a sports program right now that is in quarantine. We have our nurses affected right now with this quarantine effort we have. We have a couple of nurses that will be unavailable to us. And I talk about how hard our staff has worked. I could probably spend 15 minutes complimenting people individually just to highlight what our nurses are doing on a day-to-day basis. Thank you to the board for being willing to put a full-time nurse in every school in Scott County. That has been very, very beneficial for us as we have dealt with this. Ms. Howard, Nurse Howard, works tirelessly every day with the Virginia Department of Health, and we make the right decision for our kids. It's a tremendous burden on us that we act quickly enough that we don't potentially endanger more kids and staff. I know that you all have been so kind in a lot of the words that our parents have said, and I'm thankful for that. We can feel your all support behind us as we're trying to make the best decision for our kids. And it is a big burden to make sure we do the right thing, that we don't affect more lives or more individuals. It's a tough decision to